Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the series LLM Ops and the OpenVINO Toolkit. And in today's video, I'm going to use the new model from Meta, the Llama 3.2, 3 billion of parameters in Strat. It's a model that the Meta AI had recently released. So if you want to use it, you will have to ask for permission to use it in the Hugging Face Hub website. And what we are going to do today is transform the model to format ER, the proprietary format of Meta. OpenVINO, and then on we will use Octimoon, the integration with Octimoon library from Transformers to quantize the model to integer 4. After that, we will run inference in the GPU using the, well, some of the COT chain of thoughts prompts that I used to use to test the models. And we will be doing, as I said, the inference in the CPU. As usual, I have prepared an output. Later on, I will upload to the repository, and I will put a link into the video description to you get access to it and be able to replicate this in your local environment. First of all, the model. The model is recently released by Meta. You had access to it on the repository in Hugging Face. It's come with two different versions: 1 billion parameters and 3 billion parameters, multilingual both. A model which, in my opinion, very well trained as well, is at the same level of a previous one that we already tested on the channel, the 3.18 billion. You can take a look to the benchmarks, and then it's in general close. Some of the benchmarks is even better than the structured model. That is the one this is the base pre-trained models, and then you can take a look to the performance in some of the capabilities and the benchmark use, and then it's very close to the 8 billion when it's a model that essentially is less than half of the 8 billion model. We tested in the channel the 8 billion parameters, and the test was with the COT prompts was very satisfactory. And also we do a quantization with four integer, and it was really working on the CPU as well with OpenVINO runtime, and the prompts it answered it correctly, all the prompts. Some of the performance are even higher than the 8 billion, but well, very close, a little bit less. That in reasoning, that is the one that we are going to test today. The performance is very close to the 8 billion. In some other, as I said, obviously had to be lower, because the model is really small in comparison with the 8 billion, but in any case, really good. Spanish, Italian, German, French, Hindi, and Thai. Take a look as well to the size of the model, 6.4 gigabytes. Later on, we will see the size of the two tensors. Here you have the original in PyTorch format, 6.43 gigabytes. So it's I cannot run the original model on my domestic GPU. It's bigger. I have a GPU GeForce 1650 with 4 gigabytes, so it's too big for my GPU. And then once it's transformed to 4 integer, I will be able to run it, because you can see here, once it's transformed, the model in total is 1.6 gigabytes. We reduce jatu zitu one fourth, so to 20% of the original size, from 6.4 to 1.6 is 25% of the original size. As you probably know, theoretically, if we will be able to quantize all the layers of the model, we will be reducing the model to 8 times, from floating point 32 to integer 4 is we move from 32 bytes to 4 bytes. So, well, theoretically, it's a 8 times reduction, but you probably know that we don't quantize all the layers of the model. We will take a look later if you go to the model. So when you transform the model to OpenBINO format, first of all, we convert it to IR, the proprietary format of OpenBINO. You get two files, the model itself and the XML that is a well, the metadata of all the layers that you have in the model, and then you can see here that some of the layers are not transformed, it's still in floating point 32, and some others they are converted to integer 4. As you can take a look one by one, integer 64, integer 4. So, yeah, that's because some of the layers. We cannot convert it, we cannot quantize it. This is happening with any kind of model. The quantization is only applicable to the attention layers, to in some cases to the convolutional layers case that we are working with computer vision models, but it's not applicable to, for example, batch normalization layers or some others like yeah, exactly. It's not applicable to us, but in any case, we reduce the model to 20%, 25% of the original size. Which is a really big reduction in terms of size. That will allow me, in my case, to run even in my GPU. We will not run it. My plan is to run it in CPU. If you are interested, OpenBINO in any case is not the best runtime to run models in GPU. If you plan to run a model in a GPU, I recommend you to use TensorRT from NVIDIA, which you also have some videos on the channel because obviously TensorRT is designed by NVIDIA. Obviously, it's much better to use the original. Also, like OpenBINO is developed under the hood in C++, and then here we are using an interface, an API in Python to interact with the code in C++. The TensorRT is exactly the same. That is developed in C++, but obviously developed by NVIDIA. NVIDIA engineers know better how to run code in their GPUs rather than OpenBINO. If you have other requirements like running in for example, in AMD or in other GPUs rather than in NVIDIA GPUs, the choice is obviously OpenBINO or ONNX, the Microsoft runtime. But if you plan to run the inference in a NVIDIA GPU, the choice is TensorRT from NVIDIA. With this, today, in today's video, we will do the inference in the CPU. You will see that is well, relatively fast, not a problem. And then on this open the to some possibilities to run this model in cheap hardware, even smartphones or embedded devices. Okay, here I will. You have the instructions. You have to clone the repository from OpenBINO Genai is an extension of the original OpenBINO runtime to work with LLMs. You have here the capabilities that or it's only prepared to work with this tax. It's not for everything. So it's touch generation, image generation with diffuser models, speech recognition, whisper family models, and text generation with model like Llama or Mini CPM family. So with this, this is the how to say the class with this the extension of the runtime to work with LLMs. You also have this extension to work with Optimum. Optimum, as you probably know, is an extension of Transformers, which allow us to integrate with different hardware providers or other integrations like ONN and X. Torch and hear from the this other two, which I didn't use up to now, and the partners Intel's NVIDIA, Intel is OpenVINO, AMD, NVIDIA. So there is this extension to work with the runtimes like OpenVINO or TensorRT LLM, which is the equivalent to OpenVINO Gen-I in Intel, no? You had a similar runtimes and integrations with other hardware providers. So you will need different libraries, which I give you here all what you need. If you plan to do this in a GPU, you will need to change the Torch installation. So you will need to point to a adequate PyTorch installation, depending which will depends on your CUDA toolkit, the one that you have installed in your local environment. So we need here the OpenVINO Gen-I, OpenVINO runtime, the integration with Transformers. So we point to the OpenVINO toolkit, the latest version. We need PyTorch or the Torch in this case, as I said, only for CPU in my case, and you need to point to the also the you need to install the Optimal Intel OpenVINO NNCF. This is the library to do the which do the quantization and compression in it's another library that you need is part of the is a compression framework. This is the component which compress and transform the models into IR and also do the quantization. To do the quantization, you probably know this. I explained in several videos. We need a dataset to do the calibration. Quantized models with OpenVINO have this requirement. Here we are going to use the one that OpenVINO recommend, the Wikitext2, for this kind of models and in this kind of activities, touch generation with PaaS. So to do the once you have the install all the packages and libraries you need to do, you need to have, sorry. You essentially use the Optimum CLI command, export to OpenVINO format. With the Optimum CLI, you can export to all the formats that you they integrate with. In this case, we are going to export to OpenVINO, and then on we this is just pointing to the model in Hugging Face Hub, the one that we want to convert. The tags, the weights, integer 4, grouping size 64, ratio 1.0, and the data set you need to do all layers. All layers doesn't mean that it's gonna be all the layers, because as I said before, it's not possible. You only will all the this means all possible layers. Don't just reduce to the Q, R, attention layers, whatever. When you say all layers, it's everything that is possible to quantize, quantize. And then for that, again, we are going to use the dataset Wikitext2, and this is the folder where you will deposit or place the model once is Converted and quantized. So we can, as you probably remember, we had every component that is quantized and transformed to ER format, contains two files and some metadata. This is the JSON, and then you have the binary, which is the model itself with the model with the bias and weights and bias transformed to the format and also the XML. And then we have here, it creates three components: the model, the tokenizer, and the detokenizer. In all of them, as I said, in IR quantized format. So once you have done the quantization, the spore and quantization, we just import the library, and here we have the typical. The typical COT prompts. I use this many times on the channel. You have plenty of examples. I tested in the past months ago, Mistral 7b, Llama 2 7b, Llama 3 8b, Microsoft Phi, Phi-3, exactly, the Phi-3 models, and also the Llama 380, GPT-4, GPT-4o, and Gemini, and also Anthropic model. So there is plenty of examples of doing this exercise in the channel. So you want to find something, let me know in the comments, and I will point you out to the correct video to if you want to compare what you are gonna see here with the previous ones I did days or months ago. So we just use the LLM pipeline. We point to the directory and to the device. Again, if you want to use the GPU, you will need to install the PyTorch with GPU support. And we create an object, LLM pipeline, from OpenBinoGenI GNI library, and we create here a generation config. This is the typical configuration parameters in OpenBinoG. The typical temperature, top key, top P, do true, etc. Here, just we set up the four parameters with 300 max new tokens, and we enter in a loop, asking some prompts to the model. So you will see it's taking that not much. You will see that the model again is quite fast. As you can imagine, I'm working on my CPU. It's doing a lot of things at the same time. It's not only working for dedicating the CPU for the model. And you can see here that the model is answering correctly to the first prompt. Let's do this. It's a little bit more complicated, the second one. This is the problem of the apples. I bought 10 apples. I give to the neighbor, to the repairman. Then I went again and I bought five and I ate one. How many remains? Obviously, it's 10. So it's gonna see you bought 10 apples. It's following really good the logic. So the model is well, having some good, is good in this kind of tasks, which usually are very hard for the models. The chain of thoughts, all rational, all maths, algebra questions for models usually are a nightmare. And then, but you can see here, the model working on the CPU is quite fast and answering correctly to our questions. So let's check here the other problem. When I was 6, my sister had halved my age. Now I'm 70. How old is my sister now? So yeah, it's following a rational step by step. So the model is quite good considering the size. This is the similar, even smaller than the Phi-3, a little bit smaller. This is 3 billion, the Phi-3 from Microsoft is 3.4. So you said that you have a 3 difference equals 76. Okay, 67, perfect. Let's do another question. So I'm just using these questions because this is you can see here on the repository where I upload all the videos. You have all the material that support the videos. You have the same exercise done with the Llama 3 8B. You can see here the model just make the calculations after the 20 years and make it take a look the 8B Llama 3 8B did it wrong. Because the calculations are here, this table. Now we will do the calculations as well with the. These questions are the 8 billion. This is the. Oops, sorry. The model was the Llama 3 8 billion parameters. I think it was the version 3 original, the first one. Let me check. Yeah, exactly. It's the 3. So now it's answering the 37 euros 20 years ago. 57. So this is correct. And now the devaluation of the car. So using the percentage declining balance. So here I need to put this just response here. Let me point out this. We will finish the video. So well, here this is also is wrong. This is not applying correctly the method. I did it before, and in the first in the previous video where the video I did for the Spanish community, this that was done correctly. I changed the number of tokens, but well, this is not answering correctly this right now. But in any case, this is a really really hard question. In any case, you can take a look to the previous models. You have examples here with the Llama 2 7 billions, Llama 3 8 billions, Llama instructed Llama 3 8B after fine-tuning with a chain of truth dataset also was wrong. So there is many examples in the channel. You can take a look and you will see that this question where only the first model who answered it correctly was Gemini 1.5 with 1 billion characters. So the models are struggling always with this question. None of them answer it correctly. The 380 billions or 480 billions billions parameters answer it correctly. So you can see here this example wrong. If you go here, the Llama 3 after instruction also wrong. You can take a look here. No, well, this practically now 335, 849, 3600, close but wrong. In any case, you have here Llama 2. Yeah, this is was even worse. This model finally, this was 95. Wrong, nice. In any case, here we have prone engineering. I think I have here the 53 V3 was answering correctly, if I don't remember wrong. But okay, you can take a look. You have many examples of this. This is the fuse of prompting, chain of through. Well, I think. No. Well, in any case, as I said, this is really hard questions for models in general. It's not a, a problem of the LAMA 3.2. It's a problem, general problem with this kind of prompts. Models are struggling to provide a correct answer. You can try, or in any case, with other parameters as well, you will see that these kind of questions, most of them, regardless the good numbers the model has, all the models struggle to answer correctly these questions. In any case, the model is quite good, in my opinion. It's really good, really good trained for general questions. Obviously, it's gonna fail this hard question. But I told you, it's, even if you try with some of the GPTs, you will have this kind of issues. Okay, I will upload now the model, the notebook to the repository. And that's all for now. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope that you find it interesting and useful for your training, for your job, for whatever reason are you watching this video. And if so, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, and make comments, etc. So share with your friends or whatever, just to help me to grow on YouTube. Thank you very much and see you soon.